at Hell in a Cell. It'll be the third match this week for Christian, thanks to our COO, Triple H.
And how is that fair? Explain to me how that's fair.
Oh, just stating factual information.
Christian just keeps crying and just keeps crying and just keep getting shot after shot. The guy just going to hit them a lot.
The question I have is this, guys. I mean, listen, Booker, how can Triple H find superstars like Mark Henry for putting Jerry Lawler through an announce table, yet Randy Orton doesn't get suspended or fined for attacking Cody Rhodes outside the ring with a ring bell that wasn't even involved in the matchup? Explain that to me. Explain to me how Orton wasn't punished.
It's hard to explain. There's a lot of stuff going on right now that should be fined, and they're not getting fined. Just like this man right here, Cody Rhodes, for headbutting people with that mask on. He should be fined.
Got to do something to protect himself.
Okay, but when's the point where Cody Rhodes takes the mask off and uses it as a weapon? Then what do you say, Cole? Because we've seen him do that over the past number of weeks.
Well, you do have a point, and I agree with you there. Although him using it in the Battle Royal was legal, remember, on Monday.
Let me make a point here. Sheamus is favoring that left shoulder. He took a huge shot from that, on that pole, man, on Monday night, and you can tell right now he's still feeling it.
Cody Rhodes quickly in the cover, hooks the leg.
Whoa.
Remember, Intercontinental Championship is on the line in this matchup here tonight. Cody Rhodes defending against Sheamus.
Cody Rhodes got great balance right there. I mean, take nothing away from this kid. He's a true artist in the middle of that ring. So, but Sheamus tonight, Sheamus is going to pull off the big one. And I cannot wait. I cannot wait just to get up and say congratulations.
Well, of course you'd do that. Just like you were kissing the butt of Mark Henry earlier tonight, you might as well do the same thing to Sheamus.
That's what you call it.
Cody Rhodes doing everything he can here. Retain the Intercontinental Championship.
Not what I called it, it's what Mark Henry called it. Cody in trouble, as is Sheamus. Stalemate so far in the matchup.
Cody's still going to that left shoulder. He's working out a lot of pressure on that shoulder. Sheamus got to get to a base right here. There we go.
Booker, is this wise offense here from Cody Rhodes, who earlier called Sheamus a brawler?
Definitely wise right here. I mean, like I say, Sheamus took a big shot Monday night. Cody Rhodes noticed it. Go to that injury spot, work on it, try to get your opponent out of there. That's what it's really all about.
Uh-oh. Oh! Turnabout!
Goodness, that's what I'm talking about.
And now it's Cody Rhodes, who may have suffered a serious shoulder injury.
Check this out right here. Tried to put Sheamus into that pole, but Sheamus one step ahead, knowing exactly what Rhodes was trying to do.
And Sheamus has made it back to a vertical base. The Celtic Warrior trying to get some momentum going here.
Here we go.
This is what Sheamus needed. Full head of steam. Get banged down the tracks. Sheamus at 272 pounds is so hard to stop when he builds momentum.
Sheamus just keep getting bigger and stronger and faster.
272 pounds across the back of Cody Rhodes, and now Sheamus firmly in control.
Oh, we know what this means right here, Cole.
I love this. This is the flying battering ram. Watch Sheamus from the top rope, all 270 pounds. Oh!
Sheamus, the press leg is hooked. New Intercontinental Champion as Cody Rhodes barely survives.
Look at the eyes of Sheamus right there. Like I say, man, that's a man's man right there. Sheamus is finna put a whooping on this boy, Cody Rhodes, and I'm loving it.
You got to give Cody Rhodes a heck of a lot of credit battling this in this matchup with 9 staples in his skull. Just a few nights after defending his championship in a 10-man battle royal.
Sheamus, the only Irish-born champion in WWE history, was looking to put away Cody Rhodes, who rolls through.
Oh, man.
My goodness. That's
what a collision.
We got a new champion right here.
Oh, and Cody kicking out.
Whoa, man.
Saw the look on Sheamus's face. Think he thought he won the Intercontinental Championship there.
Go ahead.
Sheamus still may win the Intercontinental Championship.
I tell you, Sheamus got momentum right now. He's pouring it on, and he's pouring it on thick. Oh, check this out. You know what this is.
Time.
Oh, hey, Christian.
What the hell?
Oh.
You got to be kidding me.
For the second time this week, Christian has perhaps cost Sheamus the Intercontinental title.
Kill switch.
Oh. something about this right here, man.
Sheamus has the chance to do something Sunday at Hell in a Cell.
Man, Randy Orton versus Christian. What a day. Christian must have a death wish. Just keep antagonizing his opponent for this Sunday night, and he still has to face his longtime nemesis.
We talk a lot about Triple H throughout this match. Right now, let's take a look at the game as he stars in Inside Out.
You guys are aware we're trying to make a movie today, right?
I have to admit, coming on set first day, I was pretty intimidated working with the Rapster.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I came in, you're all fly out with your jacket and you had the hat mm-hmm. on and everything mm-hmm. like that. And, you know, luckily it was that day where you didn't have that plaid shirt on, but like still, you look pretty cool. If the Michael Rapaport, the Raptor, is there, then what could go wrong? You're like kinetic energy, man. you're nonstop.
I noticed you get intimidated because I had to strip down and get in the hot tub.
He gets all freaked out. I wear the tank top. I'm showing off the physique, you know, like I do.
I mean, you're like the lead of the movie.
Yeah,
you're in
yeah,
every
yeah.
scene.
Did it get heat with the Rapster that Parker Posey was his wife and he doesn't get to kiss her at all, but I do?
Yeah, that doesn't sit well with me.
No, yeah. I don't think it sat well with Parker necessarily either. Matter of fact, she was, I think she might have fallen asleep in one of the scenes when I was about to kiss her. She was so excited about it. What made me feel comfortable, I'm not saying it's because you're here, is they said, well, Michael Rapaport's going to play Jack and Parker's going to play Claire and they got Bruce Dern playing Vic. And I was like, okay, I'm cool, then I can do it. I'll clean it up my way.
Inside Out.
Is an absolute goose.
Long Island IC, you see him with this video camera there. He's probably looking for the broski of the week.
You mean the loser of the week.
For the hit YouTube sensation, Z True Long Island Story, Zack Ryder.
Give it up, boy, man, that's Zack. Woo, woo, woo.
TG told me earlier he wants to take over WWE, wants to be in control like JC took over the Brooklyn Nets.
Wait a minute. You said JTG wants to take control of the WWE. This guy couldn't take control of NXT, and he's going to take control of the WWE.
You know, I see JT don't have his grill in tonight. What the hell is going on?
Booker, I know you have a ton of signature lines that you love to use here on SmackDown. Zack Ryder has one of his own. Are you serious, bro? And it's always trending worldwide on Twitter.
I really like Zack Ryder.
Oh,
I mean,
my lord. Will you guys stop? Will you guys just stop?
This guy made it.